discuss about branchial metric estimation of FIS. We already discussed the theory. So let us see the live demonstration of potential metric estimation of FIS. So in the strong oxidizing agent potassium dichromate. In the beaker we have taken reducing agent FIS, there is ammonium sulfate, and we have dipped two electrodes. These electrodes, one is indicate electrode, that is platinum electrode, other one is standard reference electrode, that is standard tantalum electrode. Okay, so to this we went and one test tube of sulfuric acid in order to prevent air oxidation of Fe2+2, Fe3+. So these both electrodes are connected to the potentiometer shown here. Okay, so once it is connected to the potentiometer, so we will take the zero threading, we are going to shake. So in order to prevent the breakage of either electrode or the beaker, we are using the straw to uniform concentration to blow. Okay, not to shake, we are not going to shake, not still, not going to shake this either beaker, because a beaker may damage, electrodes may damage. Not to prevent that, we are going to use the straw. Okay, so the zero reading, it is 278. Before adding potassium dichromate, it is 278. So we will add potassium dichromate in the increments of 0.5. You can see here it is colorless. Before adding K2CR27, you can see it is very clear here, it is colorless. Now I am going to add 0.5 ml of K2CR27. When I add K2CR27 0.5 ml, what happens? Fe2+ will get converted to Fe3+. You can see change in color. We get light blue in color. So the EMF also increases. It is around 284. So similarly, we are going to add potassium dichromate in the increments of 0.5 ml until you get sudden jump in potential. See, this color intensity will, as oxidation increases, the intensity of this bluish color also will increase, and EMF also will increase. It is 299. You can see very clearly the intensity of the FASS keep on increasing, and readings are also increasing, that is REMPs also keep on increasing. It's increasing, you can see the MF is continuously increasing. We had around 229, now it became 483, 490, so it is increasing. There is a sudden jump in potential. We saw here this light blue in color, now the color changes to green. So even now, if you have not got the jump, it implies that you have done something wrong, you are supposed to redo the experiment. Okay. So the color changes here from bluish to greenish. You are supposed to get the sudden jumping potential. Why the sudden jumping potential? You have discussed in theory, right? The same thing, you are supposed to wait until there is a EMF will become constant. When EMF becomes constant, when the sudden jumping in the EMF, you may take another 4 more readings, stop the experiment, calculate delta E. What is delta E? Difference between this EMF and this EMF. For this, there is no delta E value. 284 minus 278 is delta E. 299 minus 284 is for this value. 310 minus 299 comes over here. Okay. C Similarly, whatever values you get over here, you write here delta E by delta V. Divide these values by delta V. What is delta V? Difference in volume. So what is difference in volume? You are adding dichromatic increments of 0.5. So 0.5, 0.5, 0.5. Delta E by 0.5. It gives you delta E by delta V. So we need to plot a graph of delta E by delta V versus volume of K2Cr2O7. From that we get volume of K2Cr2O7 required to utilize the FAS. Okay. Now that we need to calculate the normality strength and weight of FAS present in the given sample. Now let us see DMF. So DMF is almost, it's around 717. There is a sudden jump. Now we're going to calculate, now we're going to take another 4 more readings and stop the experiment. You can see bluish became yellowish in color. It implies that K2Cr2O7 started increasing over here. It is 797. So take another 3 more readings and stop the experiment. So we need to calculate delta E for all the values and calculate delta E by delta V. So we need to plot a graph of delta E by delta V versus volume of K2Cr2O7. The graph we get like this. So delta E by delta V is on y-axis and x-axis volume of K2Cr2O7. From the graph, it is very clear that the volume of FAS required is 2.5. Okay, this is the nature of graph you get. Okay. So the calculation here is, so we want normality of FAS we are supposed to find out. So normality of FAS equals normality into volume of K2Cr2O7. So normality of K2Cr2O7 is 0.5 given. Volume of K2Cr2O7, we will take it from graph. From graph it is 2.5. So divide by volume of FAS is 25 mL. So normality of FAS is 0.05. So we are supposed to find out the FAS present in the given sample. But as weight of FAS equals normality of FAS into equivalent weight of FAS, and as 0.05 into 392.14, that gives 19.607 gram per liter. So similarly, the volume may vary in your examination. We may give you 20 ml, we may give you 22 ml, we may give you 30 ml. But the volume of K2Cr2O7, the endpoint or the equivalence point will vary, but for calculation we will take this as fixed 25 ml. Thank you.